Thank you for purchasing our product. This video will demonstrate the basic use of your new machine. We hope our instructions will offer understanding of the wide range of tasks that can be accomplished with your new machine. Further reference can be found in the instruction manual included with your machine. Instructions for attaching the thread guide pole. Insert the thread guide pole into the spool pin base located at the back of the machine, lining up the slot of the thread guide pole with the rib in the base hole. Pull the thread guide pole to its highest position and turn the thread guide so that it is positioned over the spool holders using the stopper as a guide. Remove the spool holders. Place the foam pad on the spool pin and then return the spool holder. Instructions for connecting the power supply. Make sure the power switch is off and insert the machine foot control plug into the socket of the machine. Insert the power supply plug into the wall outlet. Turn the power switch on. How to set up the machine using the program display panel. Turn the program selection dial to select the program number corresponding to the stitch type you wish to sew. The selected program will be shown on the display panel. Please note, some program numbers correspond to more than one stitch type. The thread tension dials will be automatically set to N when turning the selection dial, and thread tension is automatically adjusted to the proper values for the selected program. Of course, you can adjust the tension as needed according to the fabric and thread being used for your particular project. The program number selected will appear in the front face plate. Be sure to select the program number before threading the machine. Turn the differential feed dial to select the differential ratio shown on the display panel by aligning the number with the setting mark. Turn the stitch length dial to select the stitch length shown on the display panel by aligning the number with the setting mark. There are 5 needle positions available, and the colored dots indicate the needles to be used. To remove needles, turn the hand wheel and set the needle clamp in the upmost position. Loosen the set screw with the Allen screwdriver and pull the needle down. Be sure to hold the needle with your fingers to prevent it from falling into the machine. Lightly tighten the set screw. To insert needles, loosen the screw with the Allen screwdriver. Insert the needle with the flat side to the back and push the needle straight up as far as it will go. Then, tighten the set screw securely. Turn the hand wheel slowly and check that the needles do not hit or thrust the presser foot or the needle plate. The cutting width dial is located on the left side of the machine, so you can adjust the cutting width without having to open the cover. Turn the cutting width dial to correspond to the cutting width shown on the display panel by aligning the number to the arrow mark. Instructions for disengaging the upper knife. Open the front and side covers. Push the upper knife release knob to the right and turn it towards you. Turn the hand wheel and check that the upper knife is disengaged. Close the front and side covers. To raise the upper knife, push the upper knife release knob to the right and turn it away from you. How to set the two-thread converter. To engage the two-thread converter, open the front and side covers. Turn the hand wheel until the upper looper is in the up position. Lower the converter and insert the hook into the eye of the upper looper. To disengage, remove the hook from the looper eye and lift the converter up until it secures in the far right position. Close the front and side covers. How to set the sewing table. For program number 10, Always attach the sewing table to the front cover. For any other programs, always attach the overlock cover to the front cover. Also, the upper knife should always be disengaged when you choose program number 10. Either way, open the front cover first to attach the cover. Then, insert the end of the overlock cover into the slot of the front cover and push the overlock cover firmly until the tab snaps into place. How to set the presser foot lever. Depending on your selected stitch, A or B should be selected on the multi-purpose presser foot. Select A for the 5-thread stitch and the bottom cover hem stitched. Select B for all of the other overlock stitches. How to set the chaining finger. You can switch between overlock and rolled hem by engaging or disengaging the chaining finger. To engage the chaining finger, push the needle plate setting knob up. To disengage the chaining finger, push the needle plate setting knob down. Instructions for threading the chain looper tension. The chain looper tension must be threaded for either 5-thread stitch or any cover stitch in program 10. We will now demonstrate threading for 4 common stitches. Make sure the power switch is off. Instructions for threading for the safety 4-thread stitch. Turn the program selection dial to program number 1. Set the machine according to the instructions shown on the display panel before you start threading. Thread the upper looper first. Pass the thread through the slit of the thread guide bar. Please note, some tightly twisted threads need special threading through both the hole and the slot. Threading the hole is the recommended method, especially when sewing with decorative threads. Slip the thread into the thread guide from the right. When threading between the tension discs, hold the thread tight with both hands, making sure the thread is inserted all the way into the discs. Pass the thread through the thread guides. Pass the thread through the thread guide from the back. Pass the thread through the eye of the upper looper using the tweezers. Next, thread the lower looper. Pass the thread through the slit. Slip the thread into the thread guide from the right. When threading between the tension discs, hold the thread tight with both hands, making sure the thread is inserted all the way into the discs. Pass the thread through the thread guides. Push the lever down. Hook the thread on the guide and pass the thread through the eye of the lower looper. Pull the thread to the back, leaving a tail about 4 inches long. Push the lever up to return the lower looper to the left so that it is out of the way. Thread the R1 needle next. Pass the thread through the slit. Slip the thread into the thread guide from the right. When threading between the tension discs, hold the thread tight with both hands, making sure the thread is inserted all the way into the discs. Pass the thread through the thread take-up lever. Pass the thread through the thread guides. Pass the thread through the eye of the R1 needle with the threader. Finally, thread the R2 needle. Pass the thread through the slit. Slip the thread into the thread guide from the right. When threading between the tension discs, hold the thread tight with both hands, making sure the thread is inserted all the way into the discs. Pass the thread through the thread take-up lever. Pass the thread through the thread guides. Pass the thread through the eye of the R2 needle with the threader. Instructions for threading for the 5-thread stitch. Turn the program selection dial to program number 2. Set the machine according to the instructions shown on the display panel before you start threading. Thread the upper looper first. Pass the thread through the slit. Slip the thread into the thread guide from the right. When threading between the tension discs, hold the thread tight with both hands, making sure the thread is inserted all the way into the discs. Pass the thread through the thread guides. Pass the thread through the thread guide from the back. Pass the thread through the eye of the upper looper using the tweezers. Thread the lower looper next. Pass the thread through the slit. Slip the thread into the thread guide from the right. When threading between the tension discs, hold the thread tight with both hands, making sure the thread is inserted all the way into the discs. Pass the thread through the thread guides. Push the lever down. Hook the thread on the guide and pass the thread through the eye of the lower looper. Pull the thread to the back, leaving a tail about 4 inches long. Push the lever up to return the lower looper. Thread the chain looper next. Pass the thread through the slit of the thread guide bar. Please note, some tightly twisted threads need special threading through both the hole and the slot. Pass the thread through the thread guides. Thread the chain looper tension dial. Pass the thread through the take-up lever. Pass the thread through the thread guides. Turn the hand wheel toward you so that the needle rests at the lowest position. Raise the lever to disengage the chain looper. Pass the thread through the slit from the back of the chain looper. Then pass the thread through the eye on the left side. Pull the thread to the back, leaving a tail about 4 inches long. Lower the lever to set the chain looper to the left so that it is out of the way. Turn the hand wheel toward you so that the needle rests at the highest position. Thread the L2 needle next. Pass the thread through the slit. Slip the thread into the thread guide from the right. When threading between the tension discs, hold the thread tight with both hands, making sure the thread is inserted all the way into the discs. Pass the thread through the thread guide and the take-up lever. Be sure to pass the thread into the opening of the thread take-up lever. Pass the thread following the thread guide. Pass the thread through the eye of the L2 needle with the threader. Finally, thread the R1 needle. Pass the thread through the slit. Slip the thread into the thread guide from the right. When threading between the tension discs, hold the thread tight with both hands, making sure the thread is inserted all the way into the discs. Pass the thread through the take-up lever. Pass the thread through the thread guides. Pass the thread through the eye of the R1 needle with the threader. Instructions for threading for the triple cover hem. Turn the program selection dial to program number 10. Set the machine according to the instructions shown on the display panel before you start threading. Thread the chain looper first. Pass the thread through the slit of the thread guide bar. Please note, some tightly twisted threads need special threading through both the hole and the slot. Pass the thread through the thread guides. Thread the chain looper tension dial. Pass the thread through the take-up lever. Don't thread these thread guides. Pass the thread through the thread guides. Turn the hand wheel towards you so that the needle rests at the lowest position. Raise the lever to disengage the chain looper. Pass the thread through the slit from the back of the chain looper. Then, pass the thread through the eye on the left side. Pull the thread to the back, leaving a tail about 4 inches long. Lower the lever to set the chain looper to the left. Turn the hand wheel towards you so that the needle rests at the highest position. Thread the L0 needle next. Pass the thread through the slit. Slip the thread into the thread guide from the right. When threading between the tension discs, hold the thread tight with both hands, making sure the thread is inserted all the way into the discs. Pass the thread through the take-up lever. Pass the thread through the thread guides. Pass the thread through the eye of the L0 needle with the threader. Thread the L1 needle. Pass the thread through the slit. Slip the thread into the thread guide from the right. When threading between the tension discs, hold the thread tight with both hands, making sure the thread is inserted all the way into the discs. Pass the thread through the take-up lever. Pass the thread through the thread guides. Pass the thread through the eye of the L1 needle with the threader. Finally, thread the L2 needle. Pass the thread through the slit. Slip the thread into the thread guide from the right. When threading between the tension discs, hold the thread tight with both hands, making sure the thread is inserted all the way into the discs. Pass the thread through the take-up lever. Pass the thread through the thread guides. Pass the thread through the eye of the L2 needle with the threader. Instructions for threading for the triple top cover stitch. Turn the program selection dial to program number 10. Set the machine according to the instructions shown on the display panel before you start threading. Before threading, attach the top cover foot, spreader device, and top cover guide to the machine. Press the lever on the back of the presser foot to release the multi-purpose presser foot. Attach the blue transparent top cover foot R. Insert the spreader device into the slot and tighten the screw with the Allen screwdriver. Slightly loosen the R1 and R2 needle screws and insert the round top cover guide into the R1 and R2 needle holes. Firmly tighten only the R2 needle screw. Swing down the top cover lever. Turn the hand wheel towards you and check that the spreader device moves properly. Thread the chain looper first. Pass the thread through the slit of the thread guide bar. Please note, some tightly twisted threads need special threading through both the hole and the slot. Pass the thread through the thread guide. Thread the chain looper tension dial. Pass the thread through the take-up lever. Don't thread these thread guides. Pass the thread through the thread guide. Turn the hand wheel toward you so that the needle rests at the lowest position. Raise the lever to disengage the chain looper. Pass the thread through the slit from the back of the chain looper. Then pass the thread through the eye on the left side. Pull the thread to the back, leaving a tail about 4 inches long. Lower the lever to set the chain looper to the far left. Turn the hand wheel toward you so that the needle rests at the highest position. Thread the L0 needle next. Pass the thread through the slit. Slip the thread into the thread guide from the right. When threading between the tension discs, hold the thread tight with both hands, making sure the thread is inserted all the way into the discs. Pass the thread through the take-up lever. Pass the thread through the thread guides. Pass the thread through the eye of the L0 needle with the threader. Thread the L1 needle. Pass the thread through the slit. Slip the thread into the thread guide from the right. When threading between the tension discs, hold the thread tight with both hands, making sure the thread is inserted all the way into the discs. Pass the thread through the take-up lever. Pass the thread through the thread guides. Pass the thread through the eye of the L1 needle with the threader. Thread the L2 needle next. Pass the thread through the slit. Slip the thread into the thread guide from the right. When threading between the tension discs, hold the thread tight with both hands, making sure the thread is inserted all the way into the discs. Pass the thread through the take-up lever. Pass the thread through the thread guides. Pass the thread through the eye of the L2 needle with the threader. Finally, pass the thread through the top cover guide and spreader device. Pass the thread through the slit. Slip the thread into the thread guide from the right. When threading between the tension discs, hold the thread tight with both hands, making sure the thread is inserted all the way into the discs. Pass the thread through the middle hole of the take-up lever cover. Note, use the upper hole for stretch deco thread, woolly nylon. Note, use the lower hole for deco non-stretchable thread. Pass the thread through the threading guides. Pass the thread through the thread guide on the top cover lever. Close the front cover. Insert the fabric under the needles and lower the presser foot. Bring the thread to the front. Hang the thread on the hook of the spreader. Hold the thread on your left hand. Turn the hand wheel toward you so that the machine can form a chain. Press on the foot control gently to start sewing. Accelerate gradually, working up to a comfortable sewing speed. Enjoy your new machine and the world of possibility it opens in your sewing room. Happy sewing!